It's good for when I was in high school, I got caught teaching class and was sent to the principal's office. But nicer to be sent to the hall of fame.
I was in a coma.
thanks to modern medicine, I survived what would have been a deadly injury. The last years have been challenging, but nothing like that's worth anything comes easy. So I send you today because of the love and support of so many family and friends, including those who we know. It seems like eternity, but the memories keep me. I'm still fresh, playing volleyball and performing in various band groups. Because of band, I learned to be part of a team. Friday after school, we would go to Chuck a Burger. Always Steak and Shake. I miss it. I can't be stubborn. Cause that's Mr. Hanks. Isaac. Very stubborn. Somebody told me I could not do it. That's exactly what I was going to do. I call it determination or heart. My teachers called it. And the result, most people doubted my potential. During band practice, and the Hawks never cut me any slack. But he saw something in me. Probably the same thing that James Spencer saw in me. Again, the stubbornness. He gave me the responsibility as a section leader in the drumline. The lessons of team and leadership that are important in the military. I learned here from Ritenour. There are so many to thank for where I am today. Fellow Rangers who pulled me out of the canal and kept me alive. My military, the VA doctors who literally bit me through over 30 surgeries. My therapist who taught me to do everything all zombie man to lead the way fun. For buy me a house. Jared Allen Holmes for Woody Wars, who made it at home. With that fabulous tiki bar. The best part. The Joshua Hayes, Joshua Chamberlain Society, out of St. Louis, who paid for my swimming pool, which in Arizona, over 90 degrees, they help them. And the jacuzzi. And I give my tiki bar. Needless to say, I like the tiki bar. I'd expect you to thank my family, my cousin, Big Ed, who's in the Air Force, and Uncle Jeff, whose son was in the same unit I was in. My sister Shabby, who never ceases to give me crap. She encourages me to be independent. And brother Leo, into my life. And Topper, who lived from Ritenour on the night of 2000. Welcome to the box hole. My mom, Annie, you literally gave up your job to help me damp up. But you've been there literally every step of the way. Thank you for your unconditional love. Silver Fox, go dead. He received a phone call literally minutes after my incident that I was hurt. From that moment to right now, by my side, was that chair technically. You made me laugh when I needed it the most. You've handled the amount of paperwork. My personal secretary. Welcome to the foxhole with me, Chris. I wouldn't be here without you. Love you guys so much. There is no soldier that serves alone. Since 9/11, more than 2 million troops who have been in the war zone. Thousands have given their lives. Like Martin Niederberger Sanchez, who was killed on the blast where I was thrown like a rag doll. Let the James run to me like David Hasselhoff. Tens of thousands of service members have been injured. Many more have traumatic brain injury or PTSD. They care for more than 5 million caregivers like any dead. And the civil fight, in honoring me, you honor the Americans as well. But we can never thank them or support them enough. My life changed yet again when President Obama told my story to America. It helped out to highlight the obligations as Americans we owe to other veterans and wounded warriors. And give me the new opportunity to use my story to help others. It's not the life I expected, but it's the life I was literally given. On that day in Afghanistan, I was on house bed. And now I'm trying to make the most of extra. The time I was given, as you can tell, it's hard for me to speak. But I have a voice on it. I will keep raising my voice for other veterans. It can be a struggle to give a footing, but I still stand. I keep standing for all the wounded warriors and the care they deserve. To be frank, somebody always has the worst when you're in a slump. every single wounded warrior in America deserves the same. My new mission, to enlighten the public that we still have a conflict without going into politics. This is my new mission, and I'm just getting started. In closing, I hope my story can be an example to people. Even if you never wear the uniform, but we all have challenges in our families, our jobs, and in our lives. We all get frustrated. Everybody falls down. It's all about getting up and pushing forward. And we hear the voice of doubt. It says maybe we're not strong enough. Maybe we cannot get back up. Maybe we can't go on. But I'm here to tell you, if I can pick myself back up, and push on, then you can too. Nothing left that's worth anything is easy. Don't ever give up. Never quit. Thank you for this incredible honor. Thank you for having